All right, part three, Monday, 12th, July, or section three. You can watch these out of order if you want, but it doesn't really matter. But today's videos might be better being watched 1, 2, 3, because we found subjects kind of led into one another. And last video, we went slightly over 20 minutes. Due to my little lag, I forgot to check the video time, but it's, so I'm going to have to figure out a way to split that 3GP format file. So I'll figure out a way to do it so I can get it up on Facebook. I'll do it. One way or another, it'll be done.
Yeah.
I can handle it. But let's get down to it. Where do we just leave off? Yeah, we're talking about that you are God. Yeah. All of you are gods. And when you think about God, it's not, don't think about a God in the throne with furious anger and hatred punishing people. Yeah. You know, that's not the kind of God you are or any infinite is. It's you're a loving God, like loving everyone without judgment and being kind and gentle, you know, and creating your reality as you see fit.
Right.
You know, that's what you choose, you know.
What would you do?
What would you do?
Yeah.
And consider how you want to be treated, too, because part of being that God is that, you know, whatever you end up doing to the other gods in the equation, if you do something to other ones, it always is going to be yours to deal with in the end, of course. You'll have to pay for your actions.
Mm-hmm. Definitely, you know. I mean, you are the leader and the destiny of your destination, you know. You're the one, the creator of your own happiness. You know, you are the leader. You know, you have a lot on you. You know that. You know, you're responsible for knowing what's in your heart. You know, if you can give good advice, you know, and can't follow it, then you have to reevaluate. You know what you're doing, because I know I do the same thing sometimes. I have to think about my own advice. You know, what's good for people you love is probably you should follow first. You know. Just reevaluate what you're saying. It's like you and your heart know 100% what's the right thing to do.
And your soul.
Yeah.
It's within your soul. Look within yourself, like Jeremy just said. The answers come from within. I know that sounds kind of a corny thing that's a lot commonly said, but there is truth to that.
Yeah.
The answers are within you, me, all of us, no matter what you have or haven't done in life, no matter what you have done on a spiritual path or have not. What religion you might believe in or don't, it's always going to be there. That spark of God, the God within, you know, the answer, the infinite is in within each one of us. And the infinite includes every answer to what was, is, and will, still will, is to come. So it's within you, the answer, all those answers. So that's something to really remember. It's some deep stuff sounding stuff there, but it's true. It's very simple at heart. Once you really understand it, it becomes so simple.
Yeah.
It's so obvious. When you really get the hang of it, it's like you're going to laugh. You're like, ha, 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 ha. You just break out laughing and enjoy. You laugh and joy because you realize, oh, man, this is I can't believe it. It's been here all along.
Yeah.
And it's just been right here, and I never noticed it till now. And then that'll bring out that joy in you. You'll just be so happy when you attain that knowledge.
Yeah.
And remember that knowledge. Not attain it, you already have it. Once you find it within you.
You have to let the little things go, you know. I had a song called Mantra Man that says, you know, now it's time to let it go. You know, and I said it over and over, you know, things change. Absolutely, you know. Not the same, you know. Just wanted to tell you my mantra is let it go, you know, it's time to move on and let all this worldly stuff that we suffer on and focus on and judge on, and gotta let all that go, all the arguing that we do and, you know, the stressed out lives that we live, it's time to let that go. We need to make this world into something that we can create a better place. We can create a better place.
And it's in our realm of possibility right now.
Yeah.
You know, like, forget about laws. Forget about government, what they say is or is not happening. Only trust within what's in yourself. Trust you. I mean, I'm not talking about, like, this worldly trust and this person said or this person didn't say. trust your soul, to trust what you feel coming from there. And you know it's from your soul. It's a certain feeling that can't be denied.
Yeah, this is our chance and opportunity, our get-go, our round, you know, to make something out of ourselves, be the leaders, find out what we would do. You know, like I said, you know, when we dip into what we're saying, you know, of course we take a little bit from all good things that come from religious beliefs, regular beliefs, people just in general talking. You learn from everybody, you know. We had time to change and make a difference, you know.
I mean, what are you going to do if you just, like, what's going to happen to the world if everybody here just decides to sit on their fat asses? Mm-hmm. You know, if all of us just sit on our sorry fat asses and do nothing. You know, I'd say, well, government's going to do it, or we're going to have to wait for Barack Obama to pass a law to do this or that, or, you know, we can't do anything, you know, that can't be changed. This is how it is. All of that's a bunch of BS.
It'll come to me. It'll come to me eventually when you can go after it now, you know what I mean?
Yeah, there's no need to wait. Yeah. Start pursuing what you really dream of now and make it true.
Yeah, you know, make you know, your dreams
are there, and they're ready to be made into reality.
Yeah, you know.
Jeremy and I refuse to live our lives the way society says we should, and I knew this as a child. I remember my dad always, like, been trying to train me his way of thinking. Might have been 7, 8 years old, even that young, younger. He's like, well, a man always works, and no matter what, even, you know, any job, just to take care of things and this and that. It doesn't matter if you hate it. You just have to work anyway. Always saying that was all right. And guess what? I never believed a word of it, even as a child. Even at 7 years old, when he'd said stuff like that.
Yeah.
I knew he was full of shit.
Yeah.
To put it bluntly.
Yeah.
He was full of shit. You know, I forgive him. I understand. But I do not live that way, because it's a lie to live that way, and it's been the wrong path for me.
Yeah, because what do you do? You just live this life.
Doing what you're doing? What the fuck is that?
Work a job and just
die.
And die. You know, that's it.
What the fuck is that? Are you going to put off doing your dreams until you spend all your good years from, like, 18 years old to, like, 65 or 70 working? Then you're allowed to retire, and then what? You know? Then you're just going to find, then that's it. You have a few years to do what you really want.
Yeah,
you know, this doesn't work.
It's the same thing with judging yourself and beating yourself up. You know, you're going to spend 85% of your life just judging yourself, being worried about what God's going to do to you, what your life is going to become because you did this, that, and the other. When you're just, you know, your things are right there for you to reach and control. You know, you are in control. You know, just like, you know, what are you saying? You know, it's the same thing with judgment, you know.
Correct.
You know, you're gonna live your life in this self-imposed exile, and think that you're gonna live a life after this in a self-imposed exile. You know, because you think that this is the answer, the judgment, and everything you've done. I mean, people spend too much time wasting their life away worrying about I've done this bad, I've done that bad. Let me repent. Like you said, repentance is not important.
It's not at all.
You gotta be a leader, you know. You're a leader.
Be a leader. Get off your butt and stop thinking that you have to be a follower and stop thinking that you have no choice but to let the world tell you what to do. It's a bunch of lies. You don't have to do any of that.
You don't have to be a slave to money.
That's right. You don't need to be a slave to money. You know. You can get past that. You can surpass all of that. You know, and you're not a slave to a job either. Let me say that. That's real important. You are not a slave to a fucking job.
No.
You know, I'm going to speak bluntly here. Yeah, if my language offends you, excuse me, but I feel the need to be blunt. You know, you're not a slave to a motherfucking job.
No.
You know, now that's what, now government, corporate interests, of course, want you to think that. They want you to always stress and worry about money. To always worry about having a job and make you dependent on them.